For this week's video, I want to show you how to make a new pair of earrings that I call the Dainty Decoration Earrings. This is a version, a clear, completely clear version using Bicones, and this is a Christmas version using round beads. I've also made a couple of other samples here to show you. This one is gold lined Montana, and it's really neutral. I really like this pair. This was one of the very first pairs that I made. It's a very, very neutral color. And then I also did a cobalt blue pair. But today, for this video, I'm going to show you how to make a solid silver pair. So what you're going to need, first off, is you're going to need, this is an 11 by 2 millimeter bar link. Now, it has a hole on each side, just like this, and it's curved slightly. So you're going to need two of those. You're also going to need 4 3-inch head pins. And remember, the head pin has the flat bottom to it. You're using a little bit longer one so that you can do these side pieces here. You need a pair of silver ear hooks, some Fireline, and I've got, to start off, I've got a half yard onto my needle. You're going to need a size 10 or 12. You're going to need some 4 millimeter either bicone or round beads, and you're also going to need some size 11 seed beads. For this sample here, I'll be using the nickel seed beads with the full hematite preciosa bicones. So to get started, I'm going to take my thread and I'm going to do a knot in the very end of it. But before I pull the knot tight, I'm going to thread my bar link through the knot and then pull it tight. And I'm going to put one more little knot in here. Now you want to work with the bar or your curve facing upward. So we're going to start a brick stitch. So I'm going to pick up 2 11s. I'm going to let these beads fall. I'm going to loop the thread. First, I'm going to hold the two beads with my thumb and forefinger. I'm going to loop the thread around the bar and come back up through the second bead that I added. And I'm going to hold those beads and pull the thread straight out. And you want to pull it nice and tight. This bead will sit a little sideways, but don't worry about it because we'll fix it when we get to the end. Pick up one bead, let it drop, wrap the thread around the bar, and then come back up through that bead again. So now I have three beads, and these will slide, and that's completely okay. Pick up 1 11, let it drop, wrap the thread around the bar, and come back up through the size 11 seed bead again. So this gives us 4. Now one more. So I'll pick it up, let it drop, wrap my thread around the bar, and then back up through that size 11 seed bead. So that this is what you should have. Now I'm ready to start my little embellishments. So I'm coming out of the last seed bead and I'm going to pick up 2 11s, 1 4 millimeter, and 1 11. Let this drop all the way down to the base, skip the 11, and go back down through the 4 millimeter and the 3 11s right under it. Hold your beads and pull that thread straight down. I'm going to come up through the very next 11 on the base. I'm going to hold those beads. This time I'm going to pick up 4 11s. 1 4 millimeter bicone and 1 11. I'm going to let these fall. I'm going to skip the 11 and come back down through the 4 millimeter and the 5 11s right after it. So I'm going to go through the 4 that I added and then the 1 on the base, so that way I'm going through 5 beads. Go up through the next 11 on the base. So this is my center embellishment, so I'll pick up 6 11s. 1 4 millimeter and 1 11. Let these beads fall. Skip the 11 and go back down through the bicone and then the 7 11s after it. Pull the thread straight down and then come back up through the next bead. Alright, so I picked up 2 on this one, 4 on this one, 6 on this one, so I'm going to be working back now. So I'm going to pick up 4 11s, 1 bicone, and 1 11. I'm going to let these fall. I'm going to skip the 11 and go back down through the 4 millimeter and the 5 11s right under it. And then come up through the last bead on the row. And I'm going to pick up 2 11s, 1 4 millimeter, and 1 11. I'm going to let these beads fall. I'm going to skip the 11, and I'm going to go back down through the 4 millimeter and the 3 11s right below it. So that when you finish, this is what you'll have. If you've pulled it kind of tight, you can wiggle these and get them untight. But I'm not going to put any more knots in my beadwork. What I'm going to do is I'm going to stitch down through and back up. So I'm coming out of this last spook here. I'm going to come down through the second one, through the seed bead, and then back up. And then straight down through this one before I trim the thread off. This will secure my last bead or my last little spook here. And at the same time, it'll allow me not to have any more knots in the piece. Once I get it down here, I'll trim off this both threads. And then you'll be ready to add your side pieces. I've got my ends or my little threads cut off. And now I'm ready to add my side pieces. And so for this, you're going to need a pair of round nose pliers, a pair of flat nose pliers, and a pair of cutters. So using one of my 3-inch head pins, I'm going to take and thread on 1 4 millimeter and 1 11. Now I'm going to go up through one of the open loops on the end of my link. I'm going to thread on 1 4 millimeter and then 6 11s. You want to pull it down, make sure there's no space, and using my round nose pliers and my cutters, I'm going to cut and leave myself just a little bit of an excess piece of wire. And using my round nose pliers, I'm going to come back and make a loop. You want a nice small loop to finish off the end. Now you'll want to do the same thing on this side here. So using another, and don't throw this excess piece away because you're going to need that. So again, I'm going to pick up a 4mm and 111. I'm going to go up through the other loop on the other end here. I'm going to pick up one 4mm and 6/11. Again, I'm going to make sure that I don't have any excess down here. And I'm going to cut and make my loop. So that when you do that, this is what your piece should look like. Now, I saved one of my little pieces, my cast-off pieces, and I'm going to make a plain loop on one end. So I'm going to come down about a quarter of an inch to a half inch and bend the wire straight out and make me a loop. So essentially, I'm making an eye pin. I'm going to open up the loop and I'm going to thread on both loops that I just made a minute ago with my head pins and close so that this is what it'll look like. I'm going to use one of my Bicones and thread it on. Then I'm going to make a wrapped loop. And I want my wrapped loop to be made in this direction. So that way my earring will lay right. So I'm going to bend the wire straight out. Make my loop, or start it, I should say, and then wrap the wire. And remember, each wrap needs to go right below the wrap that you just finished. I'm going to trim my little excess piece of wire. And if you have any little piece sticking out here, you can take your flat nose plier and just kind of pinch that in. And now all I have to do is open up my ear hook. Thread the loop that I just made. Close the loop. And then you'll repeat all the steps to make the second earring so that you'll have a really cute, dainty pair of earrings. Now, I will tell you, I played and played with the counts here for how long I wanted these. On the blue pair, this Montana gold line, I did 7 seed beads, and I just kept looking at it, and I mean, it's a pretty earring, but there was something here I didn't like. So I bumped it down to the 6, and I like the 6 a lot better. So you can play with the counts there, and then you can play with the counts here. It's totally up to you. Just have fun with the project. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and we'll see you next time to learn another great project. Bye-bye.